Be aware of your consistency. So I like to put my hand in the small of my back whenever I do this. So I'm trying to put it in the same spot each time. When I'm consistent with it, then I don't have to worry about it. If I'm very inconsistent though, that's when I'm gonna be scared that I might hit my head. Are you having a problem doing your reverse backswitch? This is one of the techniques that people seem to have the most trouble with. And most of the time they just kind of end up clocking themselves in the back of the head. So I'm gonna give a few tips on why you might not be able to catch it or why you're probably hitting yourself. When you're first learning this technique though, make sure that you do use some foam chucks, because something along the lines of this is going to happen to you, right? When you're learning, it's gonna happen to you. So I recommend just using a pair of foam chucks. Do that. The back of your head's gonna thank you for that. All right, so. Now that we've got that out of the way, one of the biggest things that I see people do whenever they're trying to catch it, and now this isn't the hitting the head part, this is just the trying to catch it and why they're not able to, is they reach up very high and they try to catch with their hand back here. So now watch what happens when I do this and I miss. I didn't catch it right, right? Watch again. I miss. I didn't catch it right, you know? Sometimes it takes just that coordination trying to catch it, and if I'm relying on that every time, well, it's just gonna keep falling out of my hand. Sometimes I'll get it. Sometimes I won't. So one of the things that I want you to try to do whenever you're first learning this is I want you to do this, again, with the foam chucks, not with these because you might hurt yourself, but I want you to go here and I want you to try to set it on that opposite shoulder, just like that. So as I did this, I just brought it right here. So I'm gonna do that again. And now I'm not trying to catch it at this point, I'm just trying to set it there. Now, the good part about this is if I'm doing it this way and I just don't happen to time it, or it hits my finger, stubs my finger, and I just don't catch it, well, it's just gonna sit there. And then I can just grab it and do the same thing. So, oh, I didn't catch it in time. Okay, cool. It's still there and it's ready for me to be able to catch it whenever I need to. Instead of here, where, oh man, now I gotta restart the whole thing. And now I'm getting upset that I can't catch it and it just keeps hitting my hand and I can't catch it. So if you do that, well, at least when you miss it, you can just grab it and it's gonna be a lot easier. So that's one of the things that I recommend people trying to do when they're first learning this, is just practice putting it here. The next thing that that's gonna do is it's also going to help you not be afraid of hitting your head whenever you're just here. Okay, so the first few times people tend to do something kind of like this, where they try to dodge it out of the way. The idea is that you should have enough control with the chuck that you know that you're placing it there. When I had the foam chucks in my hand and I decided to hit myself in the head, I hit myself in the head each time because I knew where that would be. So one of the things that applies for that is just be aware of the angle that you're bringing it down in. You know, if I go more this way, it's gonna go more that way. If I go more up and down, well, it's gonna go more up and down on the way back and it's gonna hit me in the head. So be aware of the angles that you're bringing it down, and then also be aware of your consistency. So I like to put my hand in the small of my back whenever I do this. So I'm trying to put it in the same spot each time. When I'm consistent with it, then I don't have to worry about it. If I'm very inconsistent though, that's when I'm gonna be scared that I might hit my head. But if I always feel that same spot right above my belt, small of my back, well, if my hand's there and I didn't do something wonky with the actual moving of it, then chances are I'm going to catch it where I need to. And that should help you prevent from hitting yourself in the head. Again, it's gonna happen the first few times you do this, so that's all right. Just use the foam chucks so you don't have big knots in your head. And then just practice it. Now, another way that you can do this, this one's a little bit, I don't wanna say harder, I would say this is probably a little bit better for people that aren't quite as flexible with their shoulders. They just can't reach. Some people can't put their hand in the small of their back, and it has to come off to the side here. Now, when that's the case, I want you to try doing this. And now, neither one of these is right or wrong, just what works for you. So instead of going here and setting it on my shoulder, I'm actually gonna try to slide it down my shoulder. See, so I'm on the outside, and I'm sliding it down my shoulder. Now, what that allows me to do with the hand that's passing it is I can bring my hand here instead of here, and it just slides right down. And the idea of this is I'm doing the same thing. I'm just gonna try to put my hand here, and I'm going to allow it to fall right into my hand whenever I do that. So I slide it down my shoulder, and then ideally, when I put my hand here, and I go here, oh, look, it went right into my hand. So again, that's an alternative that you can do. If you're not as flexible in the shoulders, you're not quite able to bring your hand as far back and across, then you can go ahead and give that a shot. The problem with that is if you do miss it, well, then it does what I was talking about earlier. It just kind of falls off to the side, as opposed to when you miss it here. Oh, look, it's still there for me. So give those a shot, see how that works for you, and go forth and perfect your reverse backswitch.